You grew up with this like a sister, you know, from when we were really young, and I want to know how it feels. Who is the person that you look up to now, or then, as being like we feel about you?
Well, you know, when I started, the acts that were out were like the Drifters and Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, and yeah. So there was, I didn't have a lot of idols to look up to, so we had to kind of create our own kind of image of what we wanted to be like. And being from the Brewster Projects in Detroit, or what people call the ghetto, we just kind of had to make an imagination of our own as to what we would like to be and where we'd like to go. And I think that some of the people that were there for us was Lena Horne, as an image, but she wasn't doing the kind of music that we were starting to do. I was trying to think, it was Eartha Kitt at that time when I was growing up. And mostly we just had to use our imaginations and kind of create a whole new form. We created the costumes and things, and you know, moving together on the stage, and it was just using our imagination, really. But I appreciated that you did look up to us. I like that. Thank you. Thank you.
On that note, Diana, we'd like to ask you to do another song from that fabulous album. Which one will it be?
Well, I'd like to do the song. It's called It's Never Too Late. That's the name of the song.
Okay. How about it for Diana Ross?
Yeah,